And then I Googled it. Worst idea ever to go on Google and Google something like that. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to today's vlog. If you're new here, welcome. Thank you for joining. Feel free to subscribe below or leave a comment if you're new and introduce yourself. And if you've been following all along, thank you for all your support. You know I appreciate you guys so much. And if you want to stay more up to date and get more frequent and more stuff, as I only do a video once a week, just feel free to follow me on my Instagram. I'll put it below here and also in the description box. Sorry I missed last week. It was a really crazy week. My mom is visiting and she's staying with us for a few weeks, so my parents live about 4 or 5 hours away, so I don't get to see them as often as I'd like. So my mom is here for a visit for a few weeks, so I wanted to spend lots of time with her. And also, I just haven't had much going on with my infertility IVF kind of world, so that's partly why I didn't put a video up. Now, the other reason I didn't put a video up I want to talk to you guys about is that I did my second Lupron injection of the 4 earlier a couple weeks ago, and let me tell you, I have done the Lupron Depot injection 2 rounds, 3 to 4 each round, so 3 to 4 months each round, so that leaves me at probably 7 or 8 before, plus these two. And this time when I did this injection, I felt awful for 2 weeks after. So I had a headache, like a very bad headache, for about, I want to say 14-15 days, and I still have it, but it's a little bit milder. I also have had the worst hot flashes at night, which is fun. Nothing like being 30 years old, going through menopause, and having hot flashes mostly during the night, but also while I'm at work, which is not fun. And then I've also had some very serious insomnia, so I was only sleeping probably about 2 to 3 hours a night, which for one night is exhausting, but having that night after night after night after night, I could not deal. I was so tired all the time, and I was having to go to work, walk the dog, make supper, like just do all the day-to-day things that you need to do going off no sleep. So I just felt awful, and that's why I haven't been on here. For those of you that are not already following me on Instagram, I do post on there every day. So if you want to stay more up to date and kind of, I talk more about the day-to-day symptoms and everything on there, feel free to follow me on Instagram. I will put my Instagram handle down below and put it in the description box. It is Amy's_journeyTTC. And so go ahead and add me on there. It's an open account, for public for anyone, and I update more frequently, and I've been talking a lot about this on my Instagram account over the past 2 weeks. So I'm just getting around to kind of getting it into a video now, like I said, because I've just been so darn busy. I've also been working late quite frequently, and I have been working, picking up some extra hours or shifts at another second job so that I can kind of help round some money up to help pay for all this, because it's insanely expensive. And so that's kind of where I'm at. The other story or info I wanted to tell you guys, I'm gonna put it in here. Hi guys, I'm gonna do my second Lupron injection. Mixing, mixing, mixing. And I did my Lupron injection about last week, 2 weeks ago. It was fine until I got distracted. Someone came into my house while I was doing it, and I actually forgot to advance the plunger until a little drop of medication came out the needle. So I forgot to do that, and then I stabbed it in. And what that means is that my injection, my big IM, so intramuscular injection that kind of goes in my behind hip area, it had air in it. And so I stuck it in, and then I realized that it had air in it, and I didn't know what to do, because I know you're supposed to take all the air out. That's an important step when you'd give yourself an injection. But with the Lupron Depot needle, you can't actually take the needle head off, because if I could, I would have taken it out, take the needle head off, put a new needle head on, and then got the air out and re-injected. No big deal. But with the Lupron Depot injection, the needle is actually right attached on. You cannot change the needle. So I had it in there, and I was trying to figure out what to do. It was already in. I didn't want to take it out, do it, and then stab myself with the same needle. And so in a panic situation, I just injected it with the air. I was trying to tilt sideways so that like maybe not so much air would go in, which is absolutely ridiculous. Anyway, so I did that, and then I Googled it. Worst idea ever to go on Google and Google something like that. Basically, it was like, if you get air in your vein, it's gonna travel through your veins into your lung, your heart, your brain, you're gonna have a stroke, or like all these crazy things, like basically telling me I was gonna die. So I panicked. I started texting all of my friends that I know that are nurses, because I work in a hospital, and asking them. And they all were like, oh, you should be good as long as you didn't get a vein. And I didn't think I got a vein because no blood came out, but I was still freaking the F out. I was freaking out. Anyways, it all ended up being okay. If you're watching this and you do injections, please learn from me. I will not make that mistake again. I was terrified for quite a few hours that something was gonna go wrong. In the end, I got the injection in, all is well. I do another injection in November, and then one more in December, and then things can start getting rolling. So January, February, things will be happening. So I'll do another video on that next week or sometime soon. I want to keep this one nice and short. And so that's where I'm at. I will see you guys next week. Bye.